Let's talk about the skills showdown. We'll do one event at a time. You won the drone drop challenge, so how was that?
It was fun. I mean, that's one of those challenges you can't really prepare for. So I decided not to take any warm-up reps and just go for it, and it worked out.
Now, you were the defending champion for the best hands competition. Unfortunately, you did not win this year, but did you still have a good time?
I did. I had an amazing time, and I passed the torch to a guy that's, you know, has been on the scene and been making plays since he stepped in the league. So it was fun. It was fun to compete with him.
But you ultimately won the skills showdown for the AFC with dodgeball. You know, it was you against a kicker. Mm-hmm. So, you know, can you just talk me through that kind of final play?
See, I've been hearing that everybody, just because it was a kicker, I don't get no credit for it. But I think that I had a great strategy saying it was 2-on-1, and I still made it happen. But, no, it was fun, a good event. But that was the way to end it.
This is a fun event, so are you going to be dancing out there? Can we see a preview of any celebrations?
I can't give you the preview. If I give you all the previews, then what I'm going to have to show, you know? So I'm holding a little bit of something back for y'all, but I got something for y'all.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You went to UCF, and they're actually getting recognized for their national championship at the game. So are you going to be there and celebrating with them?
Yeah, I'm trying to go celebrate with them, you know, get a chance to yell national champions a couple times. You know, I'm be saying it for a long time, you know, you get a chance to be a part of a program that made history before, and, you know, 13-0, and that's awesome. I'm so proud of them. I definitely want to be there to celebrate with them.
So what do you love about the city of Orlando, and how big is it for the city to host the Pro Bowl?
Oh, it's awesome. You know, it's no place you'd rather be. You know, the weather is great. You got the theme parks. Everything that you want could be right here, and get a chance to play this game in front of the fans right here. And it's awesome, and being from Florida, you know, it's something that I hope to be in one day, and I'm glad I'm here.
I'm sort of irritated anytime we lose, so it still sort of hurts.
Yeah, you lost the skills showdown and the game, so not a good week for the NFC.
I didn't partake in skills showdown. I was there for the kids. I was at Play 60 event, so we won that.
Throughout the week of practice, you know, all of you guys had so much fun, and you tried out kicking, so mm-hmm. How was that? I saw you made at least one.
I went 3-for-4.
Okay.
I went 3-for-4.
Okay.
When you talk about the ability to, you know, go against a quarterback like Russell Wilson, which we didn't get the pleasure of doing this year, that's probably one of the quarterbacks I would say I didn't have to go against and I'm happy about. Just because he's here and the offensive linemen are, you know, 6'5 and above. I'm not sure. You're taller than him, right? Have you gone past him?
I haven't said
okay,
next to him.
Okay, like I said, you let me know when you walk by. You realize, right. Like I said, they say he's 5'10".
Okay, so he's taller than me. I'm 5'8".
Again, that's what they say. Until next year.
So should we expect to see you here next year?
No. No, you should not.
You're going to be in the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I'll be in Atlanta.
Okay.
I'll be in Atlanta.
You know? The AFC actually won the skills showdown, but do you think you guys are going to get him in the big game?
No doubt about it. You know, it always works vice versa because we won the showdown last year and lost the game. So hopefully I'm thinking the reverse juju should help us. So we lost the challenge this year. Hopefully we can go win the game.
There you go. Now you guys have a lot of fun at these practices. So is that going to carry over to the game as well? You're going to be dancing? You got some celebrations planned?
I'm not too much of a dancer, but I love music. That's one thing I told my wife. When I come back to this world, my second life, I want to learn how to dance because I love music entirely too much to not have any rhythm. But we're definitely going to, well, the guys are definitely going to be dancing, having fun, a lot of energy. Can't wait for tomorrow.
How's the experience so far? Do you have an event or anything that you've done that's been the most fun?
The Play 60 event was pretty fun. I was out there doing yoga.
I witnessed that firsthand.
It was bad.
not your best. You should probably stick to football.
Yeah, probably.
You went to UCF, so what's it like to be back here playing in the city again?
It's very fun. You know, like you said, I went to UCF, so I'm here in Orlando. I got a lot of people that went here. It's good to hear Go Knights talk about national champs and everything. So it's fun. I'm just taking the moment in right now.
Now, they're actually going to be recognized at the game for their national championship. Are you going to be tempted to go celebrate with them?
I might run out there with them, go celebrate, man. They deserve all that, you know, the recognition. They didn't get it in the playoffs and everything, but, you know, that shows all the hard work that they put in, so I'm very excited for them. I know they're going to love it.
Now, this isn't the bowl that you were hoping to be playing in, but it's still such an honor to be here. So what does it mean to you for your career to be here?
It means a lot. Like I said, I put in a lot of hard work, too, and just to get the recognition around the league from the coaches, from the fans and the team, it means a lot. We wanted to go to the Super Bowl. Didn't happen, but I'm having fun, man. We're here for the fans. We're here to play football at the end of the day, so it's still a blessing.
Are there any players that you're especially excited to be playing with instead of against?
Oh, yeah. You already seen me doing walkthroughs with him, AB. We over here just picking each other's heads apart and everything, talking about training with each other, but he's a great player. Really, everybody. Vaughn, too. Vaughn a dog, too. So I'm definitely looking forward to that come Sunday.
Now, do you have a favorite event that you guys have done so far? Is there anything that you're looking forward to besides the big game?
I'm looking forward to the Play 60 thing with the kids today, and then we're going to Universal tonight. my daughter comes in tomorrow, so you know I'm taking her to Disney. So she's two, but she be all tuned in, so she's going to be turnt. So I'm definitely looking forward to all those, and then, of course, the game. But that's pretty much it.
Now, AFC won the skills showdown, so you think that's going to translate to a win on the field for the game?
Yeah, we got the better athletes, so we're definitely going to win. We're just going to win. It's that simple. We got the dogs. We got the athletes. We put points up offense and defense and special teams. So I'm definitely looking forward to it.
Now, AFC won the skills showdown. You guys won the skills showdown, so is that going to translate to a win
in
the game?
Hey, Malik, don't hit nobody, man.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely going to definitely gonna contribute to a win. You know, the AFC got it over the NFC, and, you know, we're going to make this happen.
You have anything to say about that, add to that?
Add to what?
Winning the skills showdown.
Nah. AFC the best conference. You know what I'm saying? We got to make it do what it do. We got the cheetah right here. We got the Kareem dog, Kareem the dream, and we got the best talent. Even though they got Kamara and Gurley over there, but we the best tandem. We do this, man. We do this.
So do you think he's going to win Offensive Rookie of the Year?
Obviously, that's my dog.
You played in a bowl game here in Orlando back in college. So what's it like to return here and be playing in the Pro Bowl?
It's just a blessing, man. You know, I played my last college football game here in Orlando, and just to be able to be back here for the Pro Bowl just says a lot that where I came from, you know, just being a junior at Alabama and having hopes and dreams of having a good NFL career, and I'm able to be back in Orlando at the Pro Bowl, so it's a blessing.
Now, you and Kamara are both here as a tandem running back duo, so what's that like?
That's my bro, and, you know, just the fact that we're on the same team, that's crazy that we're able to both be here, but we're thankful and we're appreciative that the Lord blessed us with a great season and health and that we're able to be here. But, you know, we had a great year, so we got to keep elevating. We got to keep taking it to a new level.
How do you think that you guys balance each other out on the field? Now, what was it like to be a part of the Buffalo Bills team that went to the playoffs for the first time in 17 years?
It was exciting. You know, just how the fans embraced us. We got back from Jacksonville, and we found out we're in the playoffs. This city has been waiting for so long, for 17 years. That's a long drought. Think about it. Like, what were you doing 17 years ago, you know? So just knowing that it's been that long and we got a chance to really be in the playoffs, I think next year we have a really legit shot of not only just going there, but actually doing some damage and potentially going to the Super Bowl.
What does it mean to you for your career to be selected to your first Pro Bowl?
It means a lot. It was a goal that I set for myself at the beginning of the year. I had a lot of people around me who pushed me and helped me get to where I am right now.
You've had a pretty incredible rookie season. You got to cap it off with this Pro Bowl. How was the experience?
It was a great experience just being around all these great players, you know, around the league, even though, you know, Minnesota, you know, they beat us like that. But, it was cool to, you know, to be with them, and they actually are, you know, cool players. And, we just created a bond, you know, throughout the locker room, and, you know, that's what I like, to be around other great players.
You and the other running backs for the NFC have been having quite a bit of fun at practice. So you guys getting your celebrations ready for the big game?
We haven't. I know them boys already got a couple celebrations, but they ain't going to leave me out. So we're going to definitely have to work on something tonight or tomorrow before the game.
Yeah, definitely. You actually play, you know, just down the street. But, you know, how was it to be in Florida for the Pro Bowl?
It was amazing. I was mad because it had bad weather. You know, usually it's sunny a lot. But, you know, we played through it. You know, and like I said, we had a lot of fun being out here in the rain.
Now, were you surprised at all when you got the notification that you were in the Pro Bowl?
Yeah, I was surprised. I ain't gonna lie. I was surprised. You know, I had to wait till my coach told me that I was in. You know, and then I really knew I was in. So I got excited, jumped up and down with my homies, and now I was here.
I saw a lot of Airheads on the sideline. Mm-hmm. Did you personally bring those?
Yeah. They sent me a big pack for the Pro Bowl. So, you know, just throwing them out, eating them. Drew Brees' kids was eating them and throwing them out in the sand, so it was fun.
Yeah, I think you personally have made them relevant again, so that's really awesome. But congratulations on the great season.
Thank you.
It was a rainy one here, but that didn't stop the players from showing out. This game came down to the final 2 minutes, but the AFC pulled off the big win in both the skills showdown and in the game today. The MVPs were Von Miller and Delaney Walker. That's it from Orlando. For Florida Citrus Sports, I'm Margo Gill.